Welcome. Our crews have been out covering the storm since this afternoon and checking out some of those washouts we mentioned.
Yeah, News Channel 5's David Charnes began his shift in Milton and then moved on to the heart of Chittenden County. David's back from storm chasing in the dry newsroom tonight. David.
Stephanie and George, what started as a typical thunderstorm proved to be extremely dangerous tonight. We're getting multiple reports of washed out roads in Chittenden and Lamoille counties, as Tom just mentioned. Here's what we know is closed right now. Route 2A by the I-89 exit, parts of Route 15 between Essex and Cambridge, Route 109 in Jefferson, Route 116 in Williston, and Route 128 in Essex and Westford. Now, some of these roads are reopening as the water passes, but if you can stay inside, do not drive through standing water. Of course, this all starting with a second punch of rain this afternoon.
Another day of impending storms. The Peterson Dam in Milton reeling with Wednesday's downpour. Soon enough, the skies opened again, but this time drivers seemed prepared.
We've already had a few storms this year already, and usually the first couple storms of the year, that's when we get a big rush for the wiper blades and stuff.
Farther down Route 7, these high school students didn't care about the rain. It was all about the creamies.
I mean, we got ice cream yesterday, too. Actually, I had one person here when the storm, when it started downpouring, and they still stuck around for their creamy, and they waited, and they ran out in the rain. You see, it's crazy what people do in the rain for their ice cream.
By the end of this first round of storms, water began to pool along area roads, but the break allowed crews to work on damages caused by yesterday's storm.
I'm pleased that most of the damage to the city's infrastructure was superficial, cosmetic, will be repaired in the next couple of days.
By nightfall, another round of storms was too much for Brooks and Culverts. Water crossed Brown's Trace Road in Jericho. Parts of Route 15 between Underhill and Essex also were flooded out. And the rain here in Essex Junction proving too much for storm drains.
And as you saw from those pictures, 1 or 2 inches of rain can create some real trouble, and we're certainly seeing it tonight. Road closures continue to come into the newsroom. You can find a complete list on our website at WPTZ.com and check for updates tomorrow morning on TV on News Channel 5 Today. Live in the newsroom tonight, I'm David Charnes, News Channel 5 Nightcast.